G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial this week. I thought I would attempt one of the Stranger Things posters for the new season 4. I've got this little photo up here just as my reference. So as usual, let's get started. We'll start off with this background picture here of our clouds, and I'm just going to duplicate that picture with a Command J. I'm going to come down here to my live filters, and I'm going to choose pinch and punch, and I'm going to turn the pinch and punch radius all the way up. So we've got this sort of circle effect here. We'll make that a little bit smaller. We'll come over here to our move tool and we'll just make that a little bit smaller for now. And you can see just what that pinch and punch has done. What I'm going to do on that is down here on my adjustments, I'm going to add a recolor. I'm going to clip that just to this layer here, and I'm looking for this purple color here. So let's come up into the purples, sort of a brighter purpley color. That looks pretty good. Can always bring that down a little bit on our saturation, but we'll leave it as that for now. Also going to add a level. So just up on the levels, on the adjustments, we'll add a levels. We'll clip that to our picture as well, and we'll just make that a little bit darker. And on the layer that we're working on now, on our pinch and punch layer, we can call that pinch and punch, hit enter. I'm going to change the blend mode here to screen. It's got a blend mode of screen. I'm going to move it over up into the corner here. Make my picture a little bit smaller with my command minus or control minus if you're on Windows. And I'm going to make that a bit bigger. Stretch that out just sort of up into the corner here. Maybe drag that down a little bit. I'm also on my pinch and punch layer going to add a mask. I'm going to add a mask down here, clicking on the mask layer. Come over to my brush. My brush is just a nice soft brush. Colors are back to black and white, and we're going to paint in black. The flow is 25%. Using my right and left bracket keys, I can make the brush bigger and smaller, and I'm just going to blend that in sort of a little bit into the corner there, and then maybe just resize that again, tiny little bit down there. So I'm happy with that at the moment, with that sort of purple. May just drop the opacity on it. Let's go to 50, and we can always come back and tweak that a little bit later. So we've got our sort of background sort of set on that mask layer. I might grab my brush again, still painting in black, still 25%. I might just make it a little bit blacker in the edges there. Okay, let's just leave it at that for now. So the next picture that I'm going to add is this picture here of this sort of flame or just embers. And on that picture, I'm going to change the blend mode to screen. You can see that we've got these lines. We can still see these lines. I'm going to come over here to my blend ranges. And on the source layer ranges, I'm going to drop this nodule all the way down and across a little bit so we can't see those lines, and just click off the blend ranges once we've done that. We'll come over here to our move tool. And I'm just going to move that around this way. And I'm going to stretch it out a little bit. And again, we'll move this again a little bit later. I'm going to make a copy, Command J. And on that layer, I'm just going to go arrange and flip horizontal for now. Just put that one about there. Okay, I'm happy with that at the moment. Let's work on our model a little bit. So let's come over here to where we have our model that we're going to use. And you can see that I've already cut the model out using my selection brush tool. So I'm going to make a copy, Command J, and on this top copy of my model here, I'm going to come up to my filters, noise, and add some noise. About 42 I've got it set at, and hit apply. So I've added a little bit of noise into the skin, and what I'm trying to do is get sort of like a slight painterly effect, just very slightly. So on this top layer now, I'm going to come up here to layer and merge visible, just all those three together. Over here on my tone mapping, I'm just going to click on my tone mapping. So on my tone mapping, I'm not going to pick any of the ones on this side over here. I'm just going to come straight to tone compression and drop that all the way to zero. And then on my local contrast, I'm going to take that all the way up to 100. And I'm just going to drop the exposure slightly and hit apply. So once I've got that effect all set, just wait for our tone map to finish. We'll copy that, Command C, come over to our picture here. And right above this picture here, we'll go Command V, double click, and resize. And Command Zero. Now we're going to place our model that we're going to use sort of quite big right in the middle here. Looks about right. So on our model layer now, we're going to add a mask. I'm going to click on the mask and come over here to our gradient tool. Click on our gradient tool, and just about this level here, we're going to drag down. So you should have white and black. So we'll just bring that black up a little bit and that down a little bit. So just blending that in, and that looks pretty good. So what we'll do now, we're still on our mask and we're going to grab our brush. Let's grab our brush. We're still in black. Make our brush a little bit smaller. Our flow is still 25%. Let's just soften that edge there on the shoulder. And let's just soften this edge here so we can't see that harsh line on the hand. We'll swap over to white by hitting X on our keyboard. Make our brush a little bit bigger, and then we'll just take some of that away. And we're just blending our model into the picture here. Over to black just to bring that up a little bit. So just blended that in. So happy with that. So on our model also, while we're here, let's come down to adjustments and add an exposure. So let's find exposure, clip that to our model, and let's bring that up quite bright. And then on that exposure level, we'll hit Command I or Control I, and we will invert that. Back on our brush, we're still on 25. Let's change back to white with hitting X on our keyboard so we've got white. Brush a little bit bigger, and let's just brighten the face and the hands a little bit. And I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller. I'm just going to emphasize some of those highlights. A little bit bigger again. Might just emphasize the glasses there, but nice and bright on the face. Also, while we're here, still on our model layer, I'm going to add a new pixel layer. I'm going to clip that to our model, changing the blend mode to soft light. Still on my brush, I'm going to grab my color picker, get some of this purple color here that I've got. Might drop my opacity down a little bit, maybe to 20. We'll have a look. So on that soft light layer, I'm just going to add some purple to my picture, onto the hands. I'm going to grab my color picker again and grab some of this sort of brighter color here. Change over to that color. I'm going to add some of that to this side of my picture. Maybe grab my color picker a little bit brighter. Just on the edges here, we'll go a little bit brighter with that. Okay, I'm quite happy with that. Maybe a bit of that color there. There we go. So I think we've got our colors in place. We can always just on that pixel layer that we created, just drop that opacity down a little bit, maybe to 75. You can always tweak that a little bit later. And these two layers here, we might just bring a little bit closer, and that one in a little bit closer as well. So there we go. That is not looking too bad. So the next picture that we'll bring in is we have a look. We've got some of these embers floating around. So we're going to click on this layer here, this picture of the embers that we've got. Again, we're going to change that to screen. And if we click off that, you'll still see that line around it. So we'll click back on the embers up to our blend ranges. Again, let's drop the source layer ranges. Let's drop this nodule all the way down and across. Click off that. Let's have a look. We shouldn't see that line anymore. So I'm going to turn this around, bring it over about here, and just bring those up a little bit and drop that opacity down to about 50%. I might just grab my erase brush. Got that set to flow of 50. I might just take some away. It's sort of random. I might make another copy of that and bring that. So we've got some on the face as well, just sort of very slightly. Again, grab my erase brush and just sort of just make it sort of slight. Just blending those in. So that doesn't look too bad. So we've got our embers in place. Now I've done this little picture with my brush of the mine flayer. So I'm going to bring that all the way down behind the picture here. And I'm going to drop the opacity to about 25 and also add a Gaussian blur. And I'm just going to blur that a little bit. Very, very subtle, and you don't have to do this if you don't want to, and it's not in the original picture. I just thought it adds a little bit. So I'll just put that at the back there, and the Mind Flayer picture that I've drawn will be available on the Buy Me a Coffee site for you to download absolutely free, so you can grab that anytime you like. So we're going to add now this picture here of our silhouette. And I've also created this silhouette from about 3 or 4 different pictures and just darkened it up to make it look like a silhouette. And this will also be available on the Buy Me a Coffee site for you to download, as well as another version of the silhouette as well, which I will have that on the Buy Me a Coffee. So it'll be 2 versions of this silhouette. You can pick whichever version you like. So I'm going to bring over a few more embers now. So I'm going to click on this layer here. Change this blend mode to screen, and I might just drop those down a little bit to about 50% as well. And if there's any on the face or anywhere you don't want them, we'll just grab our erase brush and just erase some of those away. So what I will do now, since I don't want any embers on this silhouette here as well, I'll just copy that silhouette, Command J. Move one of those copies up to the top, and that'll take those away from there. So what I'm going to do now is clicking on that background layer, come over here to layer and merge visible. Gives us one layer, including all of these layers, and then over to my develop persona. Going to up the clarity, going to drop the saturation just slightly, and then up the vibrance and click on develop. So pretty happy with that. So what we'll do now is we'll just add our text. So we'll come over here to the text layer. Just going to drag that out here. I'm just going to use this font here. You can have a look at that font there. I'm going to use that one. I'm going to use it at about 30 points here. And just write out Affinity Return and Photo, so I've got it on the bottom there. I'm going to highlight both of those text and center. Now to get the Stranger Things look, and I'm going to come over here to styles, and on the default, let me know if you've got these. On the default, I've got these two, Strange and Strange 2. So I'm just going to click on Strange 2, come back to my layers, and you can see it's sort of given, and you can see it's given me that sort of Stranger Things sort of look. What I'm going to do on this one is right click on that text layer, and I'm going to rasterize it to make it a pixel layer. Just go rasterize. So my move tool, I'm just going to move it down here a little bit, about there. On the FX, that's already part of this layer, I'm going to click on outer glow. Just turn up the intensity a little bit to make it glow a little bit. And then on that layer, I'm going to grab my erase brush, about 50%, small brush, and just parts of it. I'm sort of just going to erase. What we need to do now is add a new pixel layer right on top. We're going to change our brush, click on our brush. We're going to come up to sort of a nice line brush like this. Our color, we'll pick the red on this Stranger Things. And then on this layer here, I'm going to zoom in. And to put that line on the top, I'm just going to click once, hold my shift key down, come across right to the end and make that line. And again here, click once, click, make that line. Click once, come across, make that line. And then I'm going to come to styles and click on the Stranger Things. Command zero, back to layers. Let's come up to the top. Maybe we could just add a final curves. Darken that a little bit. And there we go, everybody. That is my tutorial for this week on creating the Stranger Things poster. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. Don't forget to head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site where I'll have those two silhouettes, the Mind Flayer, for you to download absolutely free. But until next time, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.